After we have shown the automatic creation of MEP spaces based on an IFC file in the previous video, we want to take a look at the next logical step this time. That's zoning. Zoning is used to assign the MEP spaces to logical zones, for example, to define target temperature, but also to arrange the model once again in a meaningful way. We stay in the example with a linked IFC file where I've set the transparency of the architecture to 60% for a better illustration. In the meantime, I've already created all MEP spaces for all floors. The zoning dialog can be maximized by clicking on it so that you can work very comfortably. After creating the MEP spaces, they are initially all assigned to a default zone. When you select one of the rooms, it is highlighted in the model. Likewise, the rooms are already automatically assigned to the levels. When we select the levels in the dialog, we find the rooms sorted accordingly. Beside the actual zoning, I can also navigate to the rooms very comfortably here. Using the right mouse button and then the show command, I switch directly to a suitable floor plan with the room highlighted and can make adjustments. I can also use the 3D selection box to view the isolated room in the 3D view. But now, let's move on to the zoning. We will start with the sanitary facilities. To identify them as quickly as possible, I search for all rooms that contain toilet in their name. Now they're identified and can be selected in one step and moved to a new zone using the right mouse button. We already have three zone templates predefined for you, and I will show you how to create your own zone templates in a moment. So I select the sanitary zone template and all selected rooms will now be moved to this new zone. I delete the search term from the search box and we'll now see this zone here in the zoning dialog. Again, all the rooms in the models can be highlighted when I select the zone, which you can see particularly well in the wireframe mode. In the linear properties dialog, we also see the target temperatures assigned to the zone for the heating and cooling cases. I now do the same with the corridors and stairs, which I also want to assign to a common zone. The search also has a so-called Recx function, which means that I can filter the list based on several terms. So in this case, I enter corridor and stair, separating the terms by a vertical bar without spaces. And now I get the list with all corridors and staircases, and I can move them to the corresponding zone. We also let this zone be highlighted once in the model. Let's continue with the office rooms. These should be moved to the zone offices. So I search for all rooms with the name office, and now I want to move them. A zone template with the name office does not exist yet. Now I can either create a template for it, which we will do in a moment, or I first select one of the existing templates, here for example the template living, and can then rename the zone in the next step. Likewise, I can then naturally adjust the desired target temperatures, for example to a target temperature of 21 degrees for the heating case. In the next step, I want to define three more zones, namely for the kitchens, one for the technical and storage rooms, and another one for the shops and meeting rooms. For these zones, I will first create templates. These templates can then also be used in other projects if they are stored centrally. Therefore, I switch to the linear options, and in the building analyze area, I can now create new zone templates. We start with a kitchen template with 20 degrees target temperature for heating and 24 degrees for cooling, as well as a template for technical and storage rooms with 20 and 22 degrees, and finally a template for shops and meeting rooms with 21 and 24 degrees target temperatures. Now these new templates are available in the zoning dialog and I can assign the rooms accordingly. I search for kitchen and get again all rooms that contains this word in their room name. Select the rooms again and create a new zone using the template I just created. I also want to move the cafeteria contained in the model to this zone. Instead of using the context menu with the right mouse button, I can also simply drag and drop the MEP room into the created zone. Of course, this also works with several rooms at the same time. Another zone contains the technical as well as the storage room and elevators. Again, I use the multiple search and search for three terms, whereby parts of the names are also sufficient. If I search for tech, storage, and Ella, for example, I find all technical and storage rooms as well as the elevators. Now there are not many rooms left that are not assigned to a zone. In our case, these are the so-called shops, the meeting rooms, and the lobby. So I finally grouped them into the zone shop and meeting. Now, our rooms are assigned to the desired zones, which we can see very clearly in the model. I also switched to a floor plan, and there you can see the different zones. They can also be highlighted in different colors by assigning a suitable color scheme. This is how quickly and easily you can achieve a perfect zoning of your project with Linear. That's workflow instead of workaround.